Welcome back, Tigers. This is the next video in our Forecasting Quotas series. In this episode, we'll show you how to create two custom report types that let you generate reports from your Forecasting Quota data. While the Forecast tab is useful, you'll often need detailed reports for dashboards or to export data for commission reporting. Let's dive into configuring Forecast versus Quota reports. All right, our first step is to go into setup, and we need to create a couple of custom report types. We'll go to report type, and we're going to create a new custom report type. Our primary object is going to be forecasting quotas. And then this report type is going to be used when we want to show a sales rep their actual versus their quota. So their closed opportunity amount versus their quota that we loaded into the forecast. We'll store this in the forecast folder. We're going to mark it as deployed because we want to use it right away. And then our secondary object is going to be forecasting items. We'll click save there. All right, let's go to our reports tab. And then we're going to create a new report. We will select the report type that we just created. And then let's set up our filters. So we're going to do all forecasting quotas. We want the forecast start date to be in the current fiscal year. We're going to also add a filter here for forecast category. We only want to show the closed ones because this is actual versus quota only. And then let's add some fields here. So we want the owner of the forecast quota. We want the start date. And then some columns down here. Let's add in quota amount. And then the forecast amount. We're gonna add two summary formulas. So this is going to be our quota minus actual. This will be a currency. We'll do quota amount minus our forecast amount. And then we're going to do a second summary field, and this one is going to be our percent to quota. And this will be our forecast amount divided by our quota amount. Now, if you wanted to solve for zero, you can, but all sales reps should have a quota, so we shouldn't have to. And that needs to be a percent. All right, there we go. Let's save and run this. And let's check out our numbers and see if they look correct. So our quota amount is 200K minus 109,000. That means we are 90,000 short of our quota. So this should actually be a negative number. So we may want to flip those. And then we're 54%, 96%. Yep, that all looks correct. So let's just go ahead and flip our quota minus actual. And let's make it actual minus quota. You can do whatever you want. You can go either way, but I think it makes more sense to have it this way so you can see a negative number. And there we go. And then you can also add some conditional formatting if you wanted to make some colors in your percent to quota. So there we can see one person is above 90%, so they're in the green. Then we've got orange and red. And that's it, there's our report. All right, let's go ahead and add a chart to our report. So we'll click the settings, we're gonna do a column. We're gonna group this by our start date and then our owner. Then we're gonna do some of the forecast. Add a measure, sum of quota amounts. We're gonna plot that as a line. And then you can see here that now we can see the quota is going as a line, and then each of our sales reps for the month of July are showing, which is pretty cool. We'll go ahead and save that. And now we're ready for our next report. Our next report is going to show us opportunity data within our forecast and quota data. So one of the challenges with these types of reports is we can't see the opportunities that are contributing to the closed amount. And when you're doing reconciliations for commission reporting, it's really important to be able to see that opportunity data. So we'll need to create a different report type. Our first object is going to be forecasting quotas again. We're going to store this in the forecast tab. We'll deploy this because we're going to use it right away. And then our second object is going to be forecasting items. Our third object is going to be opportunities. And we want this to be the intersection of all of these three objects. We're going to go ahead and click save there. And then we're ready to create our report. Come back over to our reports tab. We'll click new report. We'll choose our new report type. And then we're going to create a report that's very similar to what we just created. Now, the cool thing here is you can include any of your opportunity information. It is super helpful when you're looking to compare your forecast information against your opportunities. And then we're just gonna do a matrix report that looks like this. We're not gonna add the filter here for forecast category of closed because we wanna see all of our forecast categories. We'll save and run this. And this is going to be forecasting quotas plus op information. I need to say opportunity. Op is slang, I've learned. All right, so here we can click on any of these boxes, and then it's going to show us the opportunities that are contributing to the intersection of these values. So for Calvin, he has one opportunity in commit, and then has one opportunity in closed. And then you can click on the totals here and see all that information. So just a really handy little report that can really help you with your reporting. That's it, that's a wrap. Don't forget to subscribe to Blu Tiger Academy so you don't miss our upcoming videos. We'll be tackling a workaround for forecast manager limitations, where the totals in the forecast tab don't roll up to the manager. We'll present two solutions to help your managers see the forecast totals for their entire team. Drop any questions or suggestions for future Salesforce topics in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.